seals are good. Oxygen's good. Just do what you did last time, and you're fine. Follow my one simple rule. Hela, what's my one simple rule?
Listen to Lynn. Boss lady knows best.
Exactly. Listen to me. Mining's just like any other job. Go steady. Go safe. Go home with a pocket full of credits at the end of the day.
Yeah, totally. It's just like, I work in the Star Dock. Except, with more cave-ins, lasers, and accidental dismemberment.
Very helpful. Thank you.
You're gonna be fine. Your first outing was solid. And, you know, let's be honest, it ain't exactly astrophysics.
That's why I keep him around. Good pep talks.
Yeah, and the fact that I can pinpoint a helium deposit from 300 meters.
Not untrue. A shame we won't find any down here. But the metal deposits alone should pay for our own helium. Hell, after this, we'll have enough jump fuel to bounce from one end of the settled systems to the next.
Hey, more minerals, more money. And
so the cycle repeats itself. Just no more unauthorized jumps in the House for Rune Space, okay?
He's just a big baby. There are worse lives. You know, most Dusties don't even make it this far. I have a good feeling about you.
Group hug now or at the end of the shift?
One of these days, Hela, I am going to leave you behind.
Promises, promises.
Okay, let's see what we've got. How are we on time?
A little longer. Grab some samples?
Always. But not you. Check on Isabel. Make sure she eases up on the breach. I don't feel like getting buried alive today.
Roger that.
Remember, Dusty, keep your breathing steady and never take that helmet off down here. Oxygen processors don't extend this far.
Yeah, because God forbid we drill on a rock with breathable atmosphere.
You know what I love about working in Freestyle Collective space?
You think we'll be done here
talk
soon?
Like
now I hear this is the last day.
Calva! No! Ah, no, no, no! It's a laser, not a sledgehammer! Ease up! Benning, if you got paid per break, you'd be a millionaire! Let's go!
Yeah, yeah, okay.
What do we say, Dusty? You make your cut, you get your cut. No exceptions. Come on, pick it up! Troy, what's the yield?
Minimal at this point. Occasional glimmer, but it's weak.
What do you think? Stay the course?
No, ma'am. Juice ain't worth the squeeze.
Well, okay then. Let's call this one tapped. Why don't you move over to that big vein we looked at?
Yes, ma'am.
Dusty, you're up. Grab a cutter and mine what you can. Metal deposits are in that cavern. I'll shout out when I need you.
Hey, watch it! Careful!
I'm busy. Is there anyone else to bother?
get the readings.
Yeah, about that.
Problem?
Not if you consider a spike in gravity readings a problem.
I don't.
You don't?
What we're after, it'll read as an anomaly. That's what I was told, anyway.
Okay, now you're starting to freak me out.
Relax. It's just another job. Come on.
We're getting close, I think. Yeah, everything is just... Lynn, seriously, there's something really effed up about this.
Where is it, Hella?
Through there, I think.
Okay, you're up. Something goes wrong in there, we'll come get you.
Why would anything go wrong?
Would you shut up? Both of you, do your jobs. Client is on his way.
Still getting weird gravity readings. I guess that's a good thing. Just keep going!
Do you see anything?
Come on. Okay, take it easy. You were out cold. No physical damage. Mentally, the jury's still out. You know who you are? New recruit for Argos Extractors? Ring any bells? Any of this look familiar?
Thank you.
Kind of ironic seeing a former combat medic out for the count with a head injury. But hey, it's what you signed up for. Well, you got the sample. Client's on his way. Then we all get paid. You remember anything that happened? Huh. Well, you passed out, that's for sure. Everything else, probably just your brain playing tricks. Either way, we got what we were looking for.
All this trouble for that stupid thing? Sure don't look like much.
Never mind what it looks like. It's worth more than this mine has pulled in all month. We'll be... Speak of the devil. Constellation contact is on approach.
Wait, the Explorers group? I thought they were kind of a joke.
Not a joke. You're just too young to know better.
Whoa. You don't look good.
Been a good run. You lucked out being picked up for this one.
You got a few more digs to go before I feel like talking to you. Trying to get through my shift.
You all right?
You need some coffee or something?
Lynn sure seems to like you. Guess she would know, being the boss and all.
Hey, that was my sandwich!
All right, Dusty. Airlock. Put your helmet on.
Yes, it has. That mine on Bendy, right?
Kazal, hellhole, like this place. Rare mineral contract. Your tastes are a bit more sophisticated now, huh?
So, you found something?
Right here. The new guy found it.
That right. And everything went cool? Just like grabbing those minerals on Bendy?
Kazal, and no Barrett, not cool. He passed out after the extraction, woke up saying all kinds of nonsense.
Is that right, cowboy? Went on a trip, huh? That fun, huh? Not the most gentle push into the great mysteries of space, but hey, been there.
Look, just hand over the credits, and I'll be happy to never see this thing, or you, ever again.
That's why I like you, Lynn. All business.
Barrett, the scanners on the frontier are reporting a ship coming in hot from orbit.
I really thought I lost them.
Barrett?
Stops racing.
Of course Barrett was being followed.
Now that was some fine work on the pressure. You dug up the artifact, right? That means you saw it. The visions. You're coming with me to Constellation. You're part of this now. Marvelous.
Oh, no, Barrett. No. You think you're just going to take off after the mess you caused?
Oh, right. I guess I did just put you all on the Crimson Fleet hit list. How about I stay and I send your Dusty here in my place? I know, but he's not some miner anymore, Lynn. Soon as he touched that rock, something changed. Don't tell me you can't feel it.
Fine. It's a deal. Get out of here, Dusty. You're on to bigger things. Just go. Before I say something I regret.
Well, none of that's settled. Vasco! Get him to the lodge! No deviations unless absolutely necessary, okay? Protocol Indigo.
Indigo? Again? Very well.
Oh, and hey, take this. You'll find it very useful out there. And it even tells the time. Hey, look at that. The watch fits you perfectly. Now, questions? Come on. You're really not at all curious about that light and music show you experienced? Why it only affected you? Because if you didn't notice, we've all been handling it since with no problem. The way I see it, Constellation needs that artifact, but they also need you. This mystery is only getting bigger each step we take. And you're part of it now. And Vasco, don't let him break my ship.
Effective. are down, Captain. Ballistic weaponry excels at damaging the hull once shields are offline. Congratulations on surviving your first starship assault, Captain. We should search the wreckage for spare parts and other salvage. You will need to fly close to it before we can access the remains. to the scanners. The abandoned research facility is in this direction. Alien creatures are often unpredictable. in combat.
Come on! Is that a meat? Huh?
but I am not technically alive. Detection of enemy has dropped unexpectedly. Begin search protocol. Nearby. I'm detecting a safe nearby. We could make use of whatever is inside, provided you had some digipics and a disregard for personal property rights.
Thank you.
Captain Austin. Protocol Indigo dictates that I am to return to the lodge with no...
Frontier has a new captain? You working with Barrett, or did you pry the ship keys out of his cold, dead hands? Oh no, you see, we weren't really after Barrett. Or after that ship. Every Crimson Fleet rook hears about the Frontier. That constellation keeps treasure hidden in the cargo bays. The loot from 100 planets.
That statement is partially correct. The Frontier has been to many planets and moons, but the only things held in the cargo bays are spare parts, dust, desiccated food particles, and a variety of species of ant.
I don't care what kind of lies Barrett programmed that robot to say. We're taking that ship. You're not talking us out of this score. They aren't? You sure? I'm not falling for that. Your ship is loaded, and we want it. Oh, that can't be right. You mean that, don't you? You really haven't found anything on board? Sorry, but I can't. I've heard enough out of you. Kill them!
Prioritizing our deaths over your own survival. Jump to the planet Jemison in the Alpha Centauri system, and then land in the city of New England. Do not worry, this will all become second nature before too long.
What? Hello, Barrett? Let me guess. Protocol Indigo again? And he's our new captain. My crew can take a look at your ship, and you can stop by the Trade Authority kiosk if you need to offload some cargo. Everything looks good here. I'll be at my booth if you need me.
You have picked up too much matter and become over-encumbered.
This unprovoked attack on a United Colonies research facility will not go unanswered. We'll get you settled into your new assignments as soon as possible.
You will be scanned as you enter the city. Please keep moving. Okay, no bounty.
Is New Atlantis Transit, or the NAT. It provides free transportation throughout the city. We can take it directly to the Mast District.
Today's going to be a great day. Don't you agree?
The water is quite aesthetically pleasing, or so Barrett has told me. New Atlantis relies on advanced hydroelectrics for most of its power.
We just need to convince her that President Abeo isn't the same.
It's Radcliffe.
Anywhere else.
Here we are, the lodge. The front door should unlock if you hold up the watch that Barrett gave you. I have messaged the other members of Constellation. They will be. Austin. Everyone will be in the library, just inside. If Barrett were here, he'd probably tell you that you're part of something bigger now, and he hopes you'll make this.
We appear to have a visitor.
Welcome to Constellation. We have a lot to talk about.
Would you care to tell us what happened to our friend? Why you're here and he isn't? I see. Vasco, verify.
All statements made have been factual.
This is just typical. Barrett hands over our ship and our robot to some random employee of that discount mining outfit he uses.
Walter.
And if we hadn't insisted on installing those emergency protocols, I guarantee you this rock breaker here would be halfway to Neon.
But that didn't happen. He's here with the artifact.
Thank you, Mateo. Now, let's focus on what's in front of us, shall we? What happened when it was extracted? Did anyone see anything? Hear anything? Interesting. Similar to Barrett's description of the experience, with less embellishment.
There. Are you hearing this? Do you all believe me now?
Whether it happened or not wasn't in doubt. But honestly, Country, if you expect us to believe in fairy tales...
If this is the greatest mystery in the universe, why couldn't it be part of the ultimate mystery?
But, gentlemen, can we please focus? Noelle, I think it's time we tested your theory.
Right.
See, we know the artifacts react to each other. The pieces we already have move when they're in close contact. Now, if we add this new one to the two we already have...
The artifact. If you could place it on the table here.
There were only two of them at first.
Oh my God, that's it. They're reacting. Look at how it's coming together. That energy that's arcing between them, no manufactured material in the subtle systems can do that. None of them. This proves that-
Easy, girl. Breathe. You'll have a heart attack.
She's not the only one. If they're coming together, that means there's a set.
Built by an intelligence outside the settled systems.
Still 2,000 credits for our little wager, Patrick?
You're on, Walter.
Well, if we had all the answers, it wouldn't be exciting, now would it?
Not to take away from the moment, but what are we going to do about our new friend here?
So, are you ready to get to work? See if exploration is the life you want to lead in this little universe of ours? You should take some time to get settled in. Introduce yourself to everyone. Some of our members aren't here, but you'll meet them soon. Come find me when you're ready. You and I are going to be doing some traveling together. Get your feet wet. And here. I think you've earned something for bringing the artifact to us. In addition to credits, why don't we set you up with a backpack with some boost capability? Hmm? You'll need it out in the field anyway. Just mind your head.
Feel free to help yourself.
Well, I suppose that station itself at this point.
Can I help? So, are you ready to get to work? Or was there something else? We're going to be doing some old-fashioned detective work. The artifacts are relatively inert once they're out of bedrock. That means people can pass them around, not even knowing what they are. I've been letting my contacts know to be on the lookout for strange metal objects. Get back a lot of noise, usually. But a tip from the UC Vanguard sounds promising. Felt the same way when I started, too. There's an electricity in the air when you know you're about to uncover something. But it's not just that. I want to take this opportunity to see how you handle yourself, and for you to learn more about us. I'm going to be sticking with you for this. We'll be traveling together until we either find an artifact or this lead runs dry. We'll need to head to Mast. Check in with the Vanguard recruiting office where my contact works. And listen, whatever you were before or whatever you do once you're out there, I don't care. So long as you don't bring UC security to our doorstep. Every member of Constellation is their own conscience. Understood? Good. Let's take a little stroll through New Atlantis, shall we?
That was intense, wasn't it? The artifacts, I mean. Sorry, this must all be a little overwhelming for you right now. I guess a lot overwhelming, now that I think about it. I'm Noelle. It's really nice to meet you. And thank you for bringing the artifact to us. Planning on sticking around then? Good. I think we can find a spot for you. And along the way, I can give you the very abbreviated tour. Right. So you've seen the library, obviously. Walter's quite proud of the collection, but Mateo has made more than a few contributions. Gardens are out the doors there.
Well, I suppose calling you a rock breaker may have been a bit out of line.
At least usually. Let's head up.
Still doesn't excuse it. My frustrations lie more with Barrett, not the first time his shenanigans have jeopardized one of our ventures. Not fair of me to take it out on you, especially since it would seem he made the right call this time. So, let's start over, shall we? Walter Stroud, CEO of Stroud Eklund, member of Constellation, and oft-times grumpy old man. Welcome aboard. By the way, in addition to a place to stay, the Lodge has a wealth of modification and research equipment. Spacesuit customization, pharmaceutical manufacturing, testing alien substances, the whole thing. You can even fashion industrial pieces for large-scale projects, if you don't mind extracting a few raw resources from a nearby planet, that is. I'm a fan of self-reliance, so I encourage you to make use of the tools we have to build what you need. Funny thing about companies. Stroud Eklund functioned. For years, I finally decided. Goodbye.
Bet you never expected to end up involved in something like this.
If you're overloaded, we should stop and prioritize what we're carrying.
Are you doing okay? I'm not sure anyone really asked yet. Don't want you to think we're focused on the artifacts and nothing else. You matter too. You've done something really significant bringing that artifact here. I'm Mateo, theological scholar by trade, but now, well, an explorer like you. It's really good to have you with us. Second one was on Kazal. Buried, the same as the one you found. But the first one, right under our noses for years, sitting in storage, masquerading as an oversized paperweight. Can you imagine? Potentially the greatest discovery in human history, collecting dust. Take care of yourself.
Stolen any sacred relics?
I am at your service, Captain.
Of the Vanguard, honor, loyalty, self-reliance in all your actions as members of the United Colonies Navy?
I do.
Then I'm proud to welcome you to the Vanguard.
Now, you see that scientist out in front of mast? Staring at
Sarah.
Trees. Sounds upset.
Another space explorer. Bad, hey, right? You ever think of joining up with the Vanguard? Help the United Colonies, earn some credits, even get your UC citizenship? All right. Can't blame me for trying, right? I mean, I still haven't given up on getting Sarah to re-enlist.
It's a game we play. He asks, I say no.
Here's what I got for you two. Vanguard volunteer by the name of Moera. Helps patrol the old neighborhood. Sol, Mars, Neptune, you know.
The Sol system? Which admiral did he upset to get that posting?
He's Martian, born and raised. Not like I can get anyone else to care. Word is he's got some fancy metal ornament he's been showing off to the old grounders. Matches that description Sarah gave me. Sol system has a lot of planets, but a vet like Moera will be checking in at Sidonia on the regular.
You mean hitting the bars, don't you, John?
Hey! Nothing wrong with a little refresh between patrols. I'm serious about that recruitment offer, by the way. You just come talk to me when you're ready. UC is a good friend to have.
Problem?
expecting me to jump down after you. I've always liked that statue. It's beautiful, isn't it? I wonder what the artist was trying to represent. Contrary to what you might have heard, UC security personnel are good people. And Sergeant Yumi just happens to be an old friend.
Private sector, now that's where the real.
Security scanners, chemical sniffers. United Colonies should not take any chances.
Got anything to offer?
Trade authorities always buy. Here's. Right here for you. Thank you.
Check your suit seals. Martian dust gets everywhere.
Can have it. Watch out for the robots. They're surprisingly sneaky.
Look at this place. I can't imagine being cramped down here, choking on fumes and the dust. No trees, no grass.